Professor Anita Rampal, Dr. Sybil Thomas, distinguished teacher participants, distinguished representatives of Xavier's Institute of Education, friends. First of all, I'm really sorry for having arrived late. I'm very happy that the Observer Research Foundation has partnered with Xavier Institute of Education in organizing this program today. As my colleague Aparna mentioned, we at the Observer Research Foundation are deeply committed to the cause of enhancing the quality of education at all levels, primary, secondary, college, university. And for this reason, we have recently formed a broad-based platform called the Change Agents for School Education and Research. We want to partner with as many experts, organizations, like-minded organizations possible, so that collectively we bring to the fore our concerns, our ideas, our demands, and make government as well as society pay attention to the extremely important agenda of improving education for the masses. The subject of today's program is teacher education enhancing quality and relevance. Friends, teacher education, or rather education itself, it reminds me of a very wise thought from Mahatma Gandhi, who said that live as if you're going to die tomorrow. Live as if you're going to die tomorrow and learn as if you're going to live forever. So learning is a lifelong activity. If learning is a lifelong activity, then teaching, rather self-teaching, also has to be a lifelong activity. And for teachers, especially, learning can never stop. And therefore, the fact that so many teachers, educators have come together to deliberate on teacher education is something very encouraging, friends. We have to do it more and more. And we at the Observer Research Foundation really look forward to more opportunities to partner with your institute and other institutes in focusing on teacher education and making education more quality oriented, more relevant to the community, to the nation, to the world as a whole. Just a few reflections. I think that all of you will certainly agree that quality should not be linked to only grades and marks, as is sadly happening today. If you want to make our education quality oriented and relevant, it is something that most educators know this already. Far more important than what to learn is how to learn. That is, making, enabling students, children to learn. Learnability, the ability to learn, is far more important than what is learned. You know, there's someone who says that education is what you have forgotten, or rather what you have remembered after forgetting much of what you have received by way of information within the four walls of a classroom. So what you retain is the ability to learn new things, and as well as ability to remember the things that are really useful, enriching, ennobling for life. Friends, I want to share with you something that has emerged out of the activities that we at the Observer Research Foundation have been having in the field of education, especially school education. What we are hearing from more and more teacher educators, other activists in the field of education, is that teachers must be at the center of the education system. Teachers must be empowered. And in the empowerment of teachers, I want to stress one thing especially, that in the curriculum, teacher is not just a mere cog in the machine called the education system. The teachers must have the freedom to innovate. Innovate and make learning relevant to the community, to the social, natural surroundings. Unfortunately, we have such a rigid way that is laid down by government at the top, or some people from the top, or maybe it is something that we have just received as a matter of legacy. There is very little freedom that teachers have in teaching a subject. There is a textbook, there is a certain syllabus, and it has to be simply, as Professor Rampal mentioned, it's more transmission. It's information transmission, not knowledge construction. So, you know, we had a roundtable discussion a few years ago on reforms in medical education, and we had some of the top teachers in medical colleges, and their complaint was that why does the government not trust us? Why does the government tell us exactly what to be taught, how to be taught in every single subject? As if we have no knowledge and no ability to innovate, to say something different, to make experiments. There is absolutely no freedom. Now, if this is the case, if this is the state of affairs in a professional education, if this is a complaint that teachers, professors in a medical college have, you know, our system cares even less for teachers in primary schools, secondary schools. So we must empower, and we must campaign for empowering our teachers. At least a certain portion of the syllabus, maybe 25%, whatever, it should be the teachers and the school management should be free to innovate, thereby making learning, education relevant. There are so many other aspects, but friends, we at the Observer Research Foundation, you know, ours is to those of you who may not know us, and most of you don't know us. Ours is a public policy, what is called a think tank. We are a public policy research organization and an advocacy organization that tries to influence government's policies, government's programs in various areas of concern to society: education, public health, transport, employment, inclusive development. In the area of education, we want to partner with all of you, organizations like yours, as I said, so that we can engage with the government far more effectively. And in recent weeks, recent months, we've had a good response from the government of Maharashtra. I don't know whether Aparna has already mentioned this, but if she has, then I want to reiterate it. The Department of School Education, government of Maharashtra, has, looking at our activities, has approached us and said, we want to sign an MOU with you, with the Observer Research Foundation, with the Change Agents for School Education and Research, for a very focused activity for quality enhancement across the board, especially for disadvantaged sections of the student population. Now, this is a welcome initiative from the government of Maharashtra. We appreciate this, this gesture. But it can succeed, friends, only if all of us join our hands together. And across Maharashtra, join hands with experts like Professor Nagpal, so that education becomes truly the center point of the agenda of national development. With these words, I want to thank Professor Nagpal again, Xavier's Institute of Education again, and all of you again for this opportunity. And I hope that we'll keep meeting more and more often. Thank you.